It's 10 a.m. Actually, a little bit late. I didn't anticipate that when I started this, that Sunday 10 a.m. is kind of early. And that's why I have to already thank now Jorinde for making the effort to going to the studio on a Sunday morning for us. Because for her, it's a longer trip than for me. I just have to go out of this door and go into this one. To enter the gallery. So Jorinde will show us her studio, which is amazing. And it's right at the River Spree. And at the same time, we have a show of hers up here, which we're gonna have a look at and talk about her practice. And the title of the show is coming from this work here, Real Extent. And let's see if we find Jorinde. So let me see. It's interesting day today because we have two drawers, so to speak, like people who work, two artists working with drawing, Jorinde Vogt now, and Rinus van der Velde, who did this work here later at in the afternoon. And I think it's interesting that both of them, their main media is drawing. Of course, both work also with other elements, but what kind of combines them is that they both gave the media working on paper a new relevance, I would say. So here, this is a work on paper by Jorinde, and what she's doing here, she's they are kind of like immersively created in the way that she builds a basin, like a pool. And in this pool, she mixes color and paint with water. And then the big paper sheets are being drowned in them. So what you see, the paper is completely soaked up by this paint. And it creates this very interesting kind of deep blue in this case, in other cases also other colors element. And then she decides that the frame in this series is following a certain is following the color tone. Okay, let me see. If I find Jorinde now, I still don't see Jorinde. I see that she's active. Okay, so now it should work. And maybe she can tell us about this a little bit, how, because then she inlays gold elements. So you see, this is gold applied to the paper, as well as here, you see the reflections over here. And, okay, let me see again. Oh, I see some questions here. The gallery will hopefully be open again to the public on Tuesday. Ah, here we go. We're working on a time ticket system right now, so that... Good morning, Jorinde.
Good morning. Good morning.
Thank you for taking the time seeing us.
Yeah, no problem.
And I also realized it's kind of early, right?
Yeah, that's true.
So thank
for
you
Sunday.
So, yeah, maybe we start with your studio, no? Or maybe we start with asking you, how are you doing?
Very good.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's very weird situation all together. And you see, I'm always alone in my studio.
Yeah.
And yeah, it's very, the question is, first I thought it's only for a couple of months, maybe two. And now I'm, yeah, it seems to be like for 1 or 2 years like that. So it's a completely new situation also economically. So we have really to think about what it means.
Yeah, I also thought this morning that because the measurements are getting loosened a bit up and we will be open again, I think, on Tuesday with a time ticket system, that people can book a ticket and then they have the gallery for themselves for half an hour. But then it's still far away from back to normal. I think really it's like, yeah, I don't know how this will impact our life long lastingly. Also in terms of fairs and everything, I think it's way more, it has a way bigger reach than expected. How does it influence your practice and your artistically activity? Like because I mean,
I show you.
Yeah.
I mean, I turn around the picture. I'm still continue. I of course just continue like what I do normally. And so I worked on this. So you see some parameters stay the same, but others come like always. Like it's because what I'm doing is like a constant stream life. So and there's some first levels. I'm trying different interferences now with this kind of pens on my paper, which has like a ray of light, but it's like with water washed out dark ink. Yeah.
But
at the same time, I mean, between working on this, I'm mainly doing my gardens actually at the moment.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. And cooking for the kids.
But this means you have been quite productive, no?
Yeah, I'm always doing that. Doesn't
yeah.
matter what.
No, but
yeah.
Can you use this time to work productively, or is it kind of, does it have an impact on your, because I met a painter here down the street the other day and he said he can't even concentrate. Even though his daily routine is not really so much influenced by it, but it's really kind of like taking all his energy. He can't, but you kind of like, it's like meditating. How's the working process for you?
Yeah, the working process is like always, but I mean, what I do when I see myself getting mellow or depressed or unhappy, I always work in the garden. So I'm doing a lot of gardening at the moment. But anyway, it's the perfect time to be outside and be like in closest contact to earth that's possible. That's what I do.
And the work we just saw, are they the same size as these ones here?
Yes, exactly the same.
But they have they're a bit lighter, right? Can we look again?
Yes. You see it?
Yeah. So it's in different series.
Yeah, it's ongoing. I mean, that's now 2 years later. It's like that.
True, yes. They are from the, exactly,
yeah.
Right, yeah. Yeah, yeah. And then, so this is actually more, these ones here in the exhibition right now, they are the earliest of the entire,
works, no? The yellow ones are the newest ones, if I'm right.
Genau, yes.
And so this means, because these very big ones, you can't handle them alone, no? You have people helping you.
Sure.
Yeah.
Yes.
But right now you work on yourself. Does it make a big difference?
I know, for working, I for doing them, I can do also the big formats by myself. That's no problem. It just takes longer, but doesn't matter.
No, what I mean is, like, right now you are, does the working, the work in isolation, does it make a big difference to work in isolation compared to how you usually worked with like studio assistants?
No. I mean, my own process is anyway the same. It's no difference. It's just that there are no other people in the studio, so nobody is talking to you and asking you in between. So it's kind of, it's also nice, you know, that you are that you have time.
Do you mind showing us a little bit the studio?
Okay, I take my big key here. We can walk through once if you like to.
Please.
I open all the doors for you.
So this is, it's interesting you...
So this is the main space. I can show where you come in.
You're right at the River Spree.
Yes, I show you outside. One second. Here in front of me is Alicia's office from her studio. And that's where we are, outside.
Yeah.
And you see the Spree.
Oh, I think the internet connection is not so good out here.
Here's one of the gardens. The new garden in front.
Beautiful.
Side again. Oh, that's outside. So we come in. Here's the office. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I hear you well.
Ah, yeah. Here's the office, the small kitchen.
Beautiful. So you have a lot of light, daylight.
Yeah.
Light from the
and
side.
And also if you open up the curtains, you have this beautiful view to the beautiful. The Spree.
Yeah, I think even one floor higher, it's pretty amazing. Yeah.
And that's prepared for my next process. Mm-hmm. The big papers and some colors from the last time.
How do you, so you have permanent basins where you drown the paper in?
No, I improvise them every time again. And so here are my materials.
Can we have a quick look at the feather piece you have here?
This one?
Yeah.
Yeah, can you see it?
Yeah, maybe you get a bit closer because it's an interesting earlier series. And now we kind of see it well, yeah. Where you made drawing combined collages with black feathers.
Yes.
Yeah.
You see it here.
Yeah. I mean, these are things you really can only fully experience in reality, of course, as everything in art, but...
So, next door now comes my storage. That's how it looks in here. Yeah, you know how it looks, Johan.
Yeah.
Yeah. Some cool. of the storage spaces.
So this means, like, when you do these, they are, when you, each time you build a new, I go a bit back so that people can understand this.
next door.
Gargantuan size.
So that's my other studio. And here we have all these hooks in the ceiling because we did the mobiles here.
Yeah. Which are hard to capture, but I try.
Next door.
Yeah, I hope it's kind of clearly to see.
We go up to the first floor. I run.
No rush. Can you see the mobiles? They're very hard to see on the screen, I think.
Yeah, you have to go very close. So, here you see also some more of the feather pieces.
Oh, beautiful.
Yeah,
I didn't know that they are still there. Great.
And the second part of it is here. Hard to see.
Yeah, hard to see on the camera. Maybe a bit from the side if you go to the other side.
Yeah, I have to open the window a little bit. Here is a perfect view. You see that?
Yeah.
I love it so much. Yeah.
And is it usually, do you have a lot of people walking by?
Oh. Yeah. If it's nice weather, all people who live here just take a walk.
Yeah.
And they make picnic in my garden here.
Nice.
And walk their dogs through.
Okay, now I think I catched one which is kind of way to see. So
better.
Perfect, yeah, thank you.
Oh yeah. I like it together.
Yeah, very much, no?
It's
interesting how it then connects, you know, the movement and the shapes.
Yeah.
And
I remember very well this time, and this is a long time ago now, these black feather pieces.
Yeah.
But
how do you notice a series comes to an end? Like, because you, I think interesting about your work, it's very diverse, but then it's always kind of recognizable. So it comes in, you work in series clearly, and when do you notice a series arriving at the end?
Mainly when I have done all variations and all the questions cleared up on the variations. And when I think I have done it, or a new topic comes into my mind, which the focus is then switching to the new topic. Here you see the material of the mobiles.
Yeah.
You see? So we go to the next.
Here we see also the biggest one, I think, in the show, which is in the staircase.
You make a small walk to the roof, like we go here. So you see everything from above.
So this is your multifunctional space. You can you kind of then build out to the needs you have, like basins or work on the floor and bigger.
Yeah, all the spaces are like that. So
yeah,
depends on what we are working. Or I also, for me, important that I always find a quiet space somewhere.
Yeah,
where nobody is.
That's an architectural detail I like a lot.
This one.
Yeah, these doors, kind of like, almost like dark kind discotheque.
Yeah.
And where?
It'd be nice if I could open it.
Where do the different color decisions come from?
Because the construction time was a period. Actually, I had no previous color concept. I always did it. when it had to be done at this time. And normally I started with this kind of, how we see it best. I started with this kind of green here on the concrete, on the former existing concrete. And it's like a light green, which is similar to these 19th century greenhouses green.
Yeah.
And like a historic green, which is like a medium green, gray, white of nature and light. And then I got to the back rooms, I got darker and darker. And always mixing this nature green up with the blues of my works. And then, so it came, and then also always when you use a color, the color is asking for an opposite color, or always from a color comes a question to another color. I always try to find the answer. So I have these pink rooms, for example, and light pink and dark petrol rooms and things like that.
For those who read German, there's a very interesting article online at Architecture Digest on the studio also. I will have some questions come in here. For example, how long will you have your Ründes exhibition on display? We're going to have it up for another 2 weeks. So I hope if everything works out fine, you have 2 weeks to see this beautiful show. Yes, the gallery will be open, hopefully from Tuesday on, with a time ticket system. We are working on it, and I think we can announce tomorrow. Who are the architect of your studio?
That's Daniel Verhulsdonk.
And what have you stopped doing the serious Black Feathers?
That's an interesting question, because you see it here on this piece as well. You see shapes which always, if it comes to the edge, there you can't see what is the complete form of it. And also when I was drawing this, I had no idea. It was some, they also have titles. They say they are called like from below or from left behind or something. Yeah. And it's something where you see only the face of something or the top, and you don't know the back part of the shape. And it can be like 1 meter more or 3 centimeter or 7 kilometer. You have no idea. And to the end of the series, the shape started to become like an avocado shape, and then also was like a ball in the picture. And at that moment, it stopped, because at the moment where I saw, okay, I got its complete form and an overview to it, I had no questions anymore to this.
And then
you understand what I'm talking about?
Yeah, and then this means you, and then you automatically start be interested in other topics and move on.
Yes, and after that came splashes again, and it was also a relief to finish this topic, because it was extremely heavy topic on, ich weiß nicht, was heißt auf Englisch Trauer.
Condolence.
Consolidation.
No, trauer. Sorrow.
Yeah, exactly. But in a very, maybe the wrong English word, but maybe somehow like in a glamorous way, or in a. And it was also a topic
with a certain elegance.
Yeah, a mixture from elegance and. Ach, so schwierig zu sagen. In Deutsch würde ich sagen, prachtvolle Trauer.
Mm-hmm.
And it was a topic where I worked on a topic where I had the feeling something reaches into myself, but coming from like one, two, three generations back, something which is traveling through generations into me, and I have to find out what it is. And maybe it has to do with what families experienced in wars or in relations. I have no idea, but it was very clear to me it's something which I didn't make up or was the reason for in my life. It's something which pointed into me. So this was a very difficult topic, and it took a long time, but in a way it solved itself also with this work.
And then do you associate colors with emotions?
Yeah, sure. There is nothing possible without emotions. And colors make very specific atmospheres and trigger experiences. It's like a score, like for music. If you look at a color, it makes a certain sound in you.
And actually, this question kind of fits well to these sculptures here. Where is your mathematical approach coming from? And maybe you can explain this with this sculptures group we're looking at here.
Yeah, I mean, it's not, it sounds so, it's just what you use on mathematical help. For example, when you use it all the time, for example, how long you boil something or how fast you drive, or
it kind of structures our life, no?
Yeah, how big is the space and the possibilities of it. I mean, it's what you normally, the duration of something. I mean, it's what you, everyone, it's nothing special, it's what everyone experiences.
And then what paper are you using? Unfortunately, I can't switch off the questions. Sometimes
here, this one.
Yes.
This one.
Ah, okay.
It's a, maybe, so you see it more. Yeah, it's a aquarelle paper, and it's very satiné and hot pressed. Very, very, and I have 300 gram and 600 gram. Yeah.
And do you work on different parallel of different topics at the same time?
Yeah, in a way, yes, because it's all, it's always, yeah, on 1 to 8 topics at once, but it's all in one piece. So you see also here, for example, you have the topic of the background, how it's done, yeah, how it's dyed with the blue and the water here. But at the same time, you have this topic of this line, this one.
Mm-hmm.
That's like the scope of the first action or your own scope on the paper. Then you have the second topic is this one, the blue lines. You see it here as well. Maybe you see it better. Wait. It's always on there in the background. Here you see it quite well. These mm-hmm. lines. And this is like you see it's like a back of a human. But it's what you imagine for yourself when you get focused and straight with yourself and get clear of where are the intensities in your body at the moment. So it's more like a meditational study. And then you have these small strokes in these different colors like that. Also here. And that's completely like that's something which happens with the rhythm of music in the background. Yeah, it's like a rhythm or a bass or something. And on top of it, with a different color, it's like an interference or a second beat coming on top. And you have the gold parts. That's done with a knife. And this is then in the end more like a reflection on what I did before, and also like that the idea, these are like studies, what is possible with it. You see it's done in different ways. also here, or it's reacting to different things on the previous parts. And but for example, here in this piece, you see it's reacting to the splashes, yeah? It's always,
Yeah.
So it's a reflection, actually, on what happened before.
And then there's this question here, the frames are very important in your work. Do you see the whole construct? I can't see the fully structure, unfortunately. But maybe, like, when did you start to, I would say you amplify the energy or the tone of the work with this frame. When did you start this, and how did it come?
Do you mean when I colored the frames?
Yeah.
It started when I dyed the paper, and then it made no sense to take a white frame because it imagines that it's hanging on a white wall, which is not which is nonsense. Yeah. So yeah. I just took the color of the paper to make the frame part of the piece, so it can be everywhere and all be always right. Beam is not a topic for me because frame is like a very interesting section in art because it's like the intermezzo between the art piece and the social conditions of other spaces or spaces in general, and it's a very interesting area, the frame question. But
so you kind of have it try to hide a little.
No, to not refer to any, also ich, dass man nichts annimmt, sozusagen, was danach kommt, sondern alles möglich ist, is to refer with the frame just to the picture and nothing else.
Yeah. So it kind of steps back with camouflaging the color
Dass
der Rahmen die Farbe annimmt, nimmt er sich eigentlich noch mehr zurück, als wenn er jetzt weiß, wer
er war. Exactly.
Oh, because also then the interruption would be even stronger if it would.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. It doesn't make up a new topic. That's all.
Yeah. Although I find it's very sculptural. How
I mean, you need a frame because you need to transport it and to save it.
And how they're floating, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. Actually, there's also this question why we speak English. Of course, I think we would be way more on point. In German, but we try to make it accessible to as many people as possible because it's not accessible. I mean, this is all a humbling try to replace the experience of the possibility of witnessing the works in persona, because I think they talk for themselves and you need to see. So I really hope that we can reopen next week and that you all try to make it. The idea is that you're going to be able to see the show alone plus one guest, so you would be always alone with a partner or like friend or whoever you bring, but then nobody else, so you can be even come without a mask because you're like on your own. And we hopefully to announce it tomorrow. Jorinde, thank you so much for showing us your studio, for making the way to your studio so early and sharing your thought with us. And I can only recommend to watch the Arte documentary on you making these mobiles. And also we see how you drown the paper to create the largest drawings. And you have a reading info, reading tip for us. What are you spending your, where do you get contemplate? We had some amazing tips. Klaus Biesenbach, for example, he said that he's not I asked him for his digital recommendation, and he said he got giant sheets of white paper. He's writing all his memories down on.
Oh my god. Okay, actually I'm not reading at all at the moment. I'm just planting. I'm only busy with learning about plants and really I'm only learning about nature and the botanical names and everything. That's what I'm doing right now.
How do you learn that? With printed paper or
no, I go to companies who do this, to großen Baumschulen.
Okay.
And I learn about what I find there, and also the areas where they can go, the time of the year when they flower, in which color, what kind of family of the plant it is, and so on, what they like as neighbors, all that.
Super.
You know everything about it. You have your garden yourself.
I don't know anything. It's all my wife. She knows. I don't know. I can't make a difference between an ahorn and a castania. But I look forward this will arrive in your artworks. I'm confident it will.
Yeah,
so
sure.
Thank you so much and have a nice Sunday. Thanks again for making the time. Ciao.
Tschüss, Johann. Danke.
Danke. Tschüss.
It's 10 a.m. on the East Coast. And it's 4 p.m. in Antwerp and in Berlin, and we are speaking today